Very good morning to all. So those who have joined online today, and there are some students who have given consent for offline classes also. Clear? So there is a clear cut instructions for them. If you have given consent form to attend offline student as offline, you want to attend offline classes, then you have to come offline only. Fine, do not consider that at your convenience today, I don't feel like going, so I will be sitting at home and joining online. You will be considered absent that day. Fine, but if there is an emergency, you cannot come, you're not well and all, then you have to send application in written that you're not well, and you take the permission, prior permission to attend online class, but on the condition you have to attend all lectures, not that one or two lectures you attended online and then you are asking us to mark you present. So at the end of the day, your absentee will be marked in the register. So please make sure, if you have given consent form for offline classes, you will be coming to school only. And those who have not given consent to come to school, they will attend online classes, but they have to attend all the periods of online classes. We have the record from all the teachers. Do not think ki humne ek class teacher ka laga liya, so I am marked present for the whole day. Clear? So this is the clear instruction. So let's continue the chapter. Address. Characters, you know, Mrs. S, daughter of Mrs. S, Mrs. Darling, daughter of Mrs. Darling. N number of times we have repeated. Clear? So all were present. I need not repeat again the characters. So we are about to end the chapter. Now you have read so far. When second attempt was made by daughter of Mrs. S to get the belongings of her mother, she goes to 46 Marconi Street, address of Mrs. Darling. Second attempt, and Mrs. Darling was not at home. So that's why she could get a chance to enter that house, because daughter of Mrs. Darling opens the gate and she asks her to enter the house. Only then daughter of Mrs. S can get sneak into the house, and she when observes all the objects, almost many objects which belong to her mother and her, they were their tablecloth, cutlery, silver, spoons, cups. What else? Hanukkah was there. That candle stand was there. Everything was there, but they were set in a different manner. Everybody has their own way to set the things. So she was dying to get those memories, those belongings. But when she saw the same things in different atmosphere, she hesitated. She did not have that feeling of warmth and love for the same belongings of her mother, because her mother is no more, you know that. She wants to gather the things so that she can, reminiscing her mother and all. She can remember her mother. She was missing her badly. And the theme is going hand in hand with the chapter Impact of War. That how war breaks the people, how a particular community has to leave the place, and how her mother lost her life and now she wants to recollect those things. But now when the moment comes, she has been waiting for that moment. And when that moment came, she did not like it at all. She did not want to collect those things. Page 14. Yes, she remembered one incident when her mother asked her to paint the silver. I asked her which silver she meant, and she replied, surprised, that it was the spoons, forks. Excuse me. And knives, of course. I told you yesterday, we ended up our conversation that children of the house, they do not know where the things are lying in the kitchen. So similarly, this girl, daughter of Mrs. S, she did not know ki meri mother is asking me to paint the silver. What does the silver mean? She asked that, mother, which silver you're talking about? So mother says, you don't know, I'm talking about spoons. I'm talking about forks and knives, of course. And that was the strange thing. I did not know the cutlery we ate of every day was silver. So she did not know the fact. Okay? So aapko bhi agar kitchen mein bheje, then I'll ask you, then you won't be able to find the things because your mother knows it well. So that was the thing. As a child, she did not know that my mother is calling silver as all the cutlery and forks and spoons. So girl laughed again. I bet you don't know it is either. I looked intently at her. What we eat with, she asked. Well, do you know? She hesitated. She walked to the sideboard and wanted to open a drawer. So now again, from the past memory, daughter of Mrs. S comes back to the present. When she's sitting in Mrs. Darling's home, She's looking at the cutlery, same silver which her mother wanted her to paint, being used by daughter of Mrs. Dorling now. And she, you know, invites her to have a look on the other cutlery pieces. I jumped up. I was forgetting the time. I must catch my train. When daughter invited her or asked her to let's have a look at the more cutlery we are having, the more silver we are having. So she was so irritated, maybe out of that moment, she just jumped from her seat and she said, I'm getting late. I must catch my train. She had her hand on the drawer. The girl was about to open the drawer. Don't you want to wait for my mother? So that girl asked innocently, that my mother will be on the way. You should meet her. No, I must go. I walked to the door. The girl pulled the drawer open. I can find my own way. So this sentence, I can find my own way, it has two meanings here. I can find my own way back to the house. I'll be opening the door. I'll go back. And I can find my own way means this way does not lead to me now, which I wanted to follow to get back the things. But I do not like it at all, and I will find my another way, what I want to do in life now. As I walked down the passage, I heard the jingling of spoons and forks. So that girl was still, you know, opening the drawer and touching those spoons and forks, which belonged to actually that girl only, which she was leaving the house. At the corner of the road, I looked up at the nameplate. Marconi Street, it said. It had been at number 46. The address was correct. Underline, this is the correct address, 46 Marconi Street. But now I did not want to remember it anymore. I would not go back there because the objects that are linked in your memory with the familiar life of former times instantly lose their value when severed from them. Underline this. You see them again in strange surroundings. This is the answer to many questions in the chapter. Underline from this. I would not go back there, se leke surroundings. First question is, why did not daughter of Mrs. S want to go back there? This is the answer. Fine. What made daughter of Mrs. S jump from her seat? This is the answer. Fine. Why does the moment of recollecting things lose its charm? Again, this is the answer. Fine. So there are n number of questions. I'm asking same question in a different way. So that's why she did not like it. Firstly, she wanted to collect the things of her mother. But when she saw the familiar things in unfamiliar situations, she did not like it at all. Fine. Situation is unfamiliar. Things are familiar. She did not like it. So she decided to leave. What should I have done with them in a small rented room where the shreds of blackout paper still hung along the windows and no more than a handful of cutlery fitted in the narrow table drawer? I resolved to forget the address. Of all the things I had to forget, that would be the easiest. Last lines you should understand clearly. Underline from this. What should I have done with them? The leke table drawer. These lines suggest the impact of war. That how people have to leave their homes, how they have to shift to rented rooms. And you know, you will ask your grandparents or grandparents if they are survivors of war, especially. They will tell you that during the warlike period, blackout hota tha. Have you heard about this word blackout? Only Divnur, Diljit has heard about it, or nobody else? What do you mean by yes, Diljit? Tell me, what is blackout to others? And what was the reason? So that there is no light can be seen. You know, daytime pe to it's okay. Night time pe, they used to cover each and every hole of their house, windows, doors. Pehle na, they used to have open spaces in the roof also. Usko bhi cover karte the. Because bombardment was there from the helicopters and aeroplanes and wherever they would see if there is population during the World War period, they would throw bomb. and then that place was totally smashed. So that was the way. So people were having the, you know, they have dug the holes in the on the land also. So chote chote pits banaye the unhone zameen ke andar, and they would hide whenever they would hear the, how scary it is, whenever they would hear the sound of the plane or helicopter coming, they would hide themselves in the those pits, and they would cover it with heavy tin for hours with their kids. Ki hamare ghar ke upar agar bomb girega, this is the safest way to safeguard yourself. So it is very difficult. The people who are going through the war like circumstances, they only know, right? So they have mentioned that she thinks that what should I have done with them? Even if she will get those things back and goes to a small rented room where she's living, and still blackout paper is hung, and what she will do by stuffing the objects. Aftermath of war is described here in these lines. Ki kya hota hai war ke baad? People are physically, they are affected, mentally broken, emotionally broken. That how they lose their family members, how they lose their houses and things, and it affect them a lot. So that's why she resolved to forget the address. Of all the things I had to forget, that would be the easiest. Fine. So uske liye ye easy task tha to forget the address, because she did not want to get those things again now. Yes, online children, is it clear? Send me your feedback. Vishnur, Vaibhav, Shati, Manjot, Anjali, Mitali, Jabalpur. So if anybody who wants to, Dia is not attending the online class and offline class also today. What happened to her? Anybody knows? Was she not attending? Yes. Kisne bola aapko? She has told you about that. Okay, I'll confirm from her. Because she has not been attending, I was thinking that she's not responding to anything. So I'll confirm what is the problem. Okay, the students, Japan also, Ishnur, Mitali, Khyati, Anjali. So if you want to also attend the beta classes, children are coming, they are safe, they are sitting separately. We have enough of space in the class. Fine, I'm not asking you to come, that is your personal choice. Fine, if in case you make up your mind, kindly bring your consent form and declaration form and submit, and then you have to attend offline classes. Fine, chaliye, let's do the question answers. Of chapter address. Yes. Note down beta the value points. Additional questions also we will be doing. Have you come back? Said the woman. Have you come back? Said the woman. I thought that no one had come back. Does this statement give some clue about the story? If yes, what is it? This is the first question. Fine. So online children also beta, kindly note down. Yes, this statement gives some clue about the story. The early part of the war, Mrs. Darling had shifted the important belongings. Fine, Mrs. Darling, she shifted the important belongings of Mrs. S or acquaintance from her house to 46 Marconi Street. Clear? So these included, what was there? Tablewares, antique plates, other antique things like Hanukkah candle holder. Agar Hanukkah word bhul jaye, you can write candle holder also. Woolen tablecloth. Green knitted cardigan with wooden buttons. Fine. Since Mrs. S had died during the war, Mrs. Darling did not expect anyone to come. So she started having those objects on her own. So they are asking that, have you come back? Question hai. I thought that no one had come back. That statement shows the cunningness of that woman, Mrs. Darling. That no one would come back and all things are mine. So she is trying to prove that statement gives us clue. Yes, that she thought that nobody might have survived out of the war, and mother and daughter both will be dead, and I will be That was the reason she was taking all the valuables. Usko pata tha that they are not going to survive in the war. But anyhow, there are some people who survive also. So this statement indicates the greedy and possessive nature of Mrs. Darling. What does it show? Greedy and possessive nature of this lady. Clear? You can add up more into it, whatever you want. The story is divided into pre-war and post-war times. What hardships do you think the girl underwent during these times? So you tell me, what were the problems faced by narrator, that is the girl, pre-war times? What does she face? Yes, Ashpreet, you're looking at me, then you're looking here and there. Yes, where is your mask first? Wear your mask properly and then speak. Yes, tell me what happened to the girl, what she faced pre-war era. Yeah, problem, whatever, whether it is wrong or right, whatever you feel like, speak. I want more interaction now. No, pre-war, when her mother was alive, she was there with her. Then, what difficulties she might have faced? You have to imagine. क्या किया होगा उसने फेस बिकॉज बिफोर वॉर नो आइडिया एनी अदर एनी थिंग वट एवर यू फील लाइक यस अदिति वेरी गुड शी ऑलरेडी शिफ्टेड टू अनदर सिटी एंड वेन एवर शी वुड कम बैक टू सी हर मदर सो दैट इज द मेजर प्रॉब्लम दैट यू नीड टू डिस्कस फाइन During the pre-war times, narrator lived in some other city. It is mentioned that she would come visit her mother. Fine. So during the pre-war times, narrator lived in some other city far away from home. And she would come to meet her mother sometimes. And during the first half of the war, and mother was always afraid. So when war started, the pre-war era and during the war, mother was very afraid that at any time they have to leave the place. So that's why she started giving those belongings to Mrs. Darling. That was the problem they were facing. We had to keep the things, right? And narrator lived in the city in a small rented room. So she was not living with her mother at that time. She was a grown-up girl. She was living in another city, maybe for educational purpose. They have not mentioned the purpose. Okay? So its windows were covered with blackout paper. It is mentioned in the end. She has mentioned na, what I will do if I take the belongings and I will be keeping in my rented room. Apne ghar mein to main reh hi nahi rahi hu. How will those things will, if the things are not making sense in her house, how will they make sense in my rented apartment, which is already covered with black paper? So impact of war is clearly visible. Fine. The threat of death was looming. It was still there, lingering, fine? So after the liberation, now post-war times you have to mention, what hardships do you think the girl, what do you think, your thoughts they are asking. And you have to consider the chapter also in this. So after the liberation, everything became normal and she could sleep soundly without the threat of you can say war and all. So that's why a post-war she wanted to see the belongings of her mother. She wanted to get those memories of her mother. But Mrs. Darling neither recognized her nor let her enter the address 46 Marconi Street. Second time she went over there, she touched the things. But when she saw the familiar things again, same line, in unfamiliar circumstances, she did not like it at all. She decided to forget the address. So pre-war, post-war. Dono apne do paragraphs mein batane hai. Clear? Next is, why did the narrator of the story want to forget the address? This you have to tell me. Yes, Harnoor, what do you think? Why she decided to forget the address? Same thing I'm repeating again and again. Wahi kuch hi aana. She was sad. She would, yes, that can be the reason. After getting the things, she can again miss her mother badly. Yes. Any other? Divnur, you also speak better. English speaking monitor. Speak now. Why do you think she wants to forget the address? She did not like the setting of familiar things and unfamiliar. She thought it is already been in use by them. I don't want to use those things now. That can be the reason. What else? Yes, Sahaspreet, what do you think? Yes, so anybody else is using it. She doesn't want to be used again. So that can be the reason. So n number of reasons are there, but yes, narrator remembered the address her mother told her once. It was number 46 Marconi Street. But when she found herself in the midst of things, she wanted to see again, but they were set in different circumstance, in a tasteless manner. She tried to touch them. She tried to find that burnt mark on the tablecloth. She tried to have a look on the silver which her mother wanted her to paint. Her memories were associated with those objects in a different way. Mrs. Darling and her daughter have been using those things in a different way. For Mrs. S's daughter, they were memories. And for Mrs. Darling and her daughter, they were objects to be used. They were beautiful objects. They were considering it as materialistic thing only. So for her, they were not objects. They were memories of her mother, actually. She has lost her mother in war. Clear? So that was the reason. So all the objects lost their value because her mother is no more, because mother is separated from her. Then she made up her mind, what is the fun of, and moreover, there are many reasons, beta. She thought at the end, why would I keep those things to the rented room? Fine, there will be no fun of keeping those things in that small apartment which I am living. So that's why she decided to forget the address. Kitne reasons ho gaye hamare paas? Theek hai, all the reasons you have to mention. Very important question. The address is a story of human predicament that follows war. Theme aa gayi hai isme. Excuse me, just let me have some water. So, firstly, we'll mention impact of war. Clear? They are asking us story of human predicament that follows war. Comment. It is your comment only. So, how human beings are and how they go through the impact of war, how they are mentally, emotionally, physically changed, they lose their family members. So, you have to tell that war creates many unpleasant situations for people. Clear? Sometimes it becomes difficult to handle those situations many a times. So human predicament that follows war is illustrated through the experience of the narrator itself. Narrator is representing that emotion of human predicament. She is representing all those people who are the survivors of war. Who is the representative of Mrs. S' daughter? Daughter of Mrs. S. She is the representing all the survivors of war. That how war impacts them mentally, physically, socially. They are not supposed to meet anyone. They lose their family members. She lost her mother in the war. Fine. Her memories were associated. She lost all those objects also, which were associated with the memories of her mother. So, yes, this is the story of human predicament that follows war. Clear? And how, again, same thing you will mention, that all the valuables she tries to search, but everything after liberation was normalizing. She tried to search for those valuables at least that she can see and touch and miss her mother and recall her fond memories. But even she could not get those back. So that tells that how war impacts the people in a very bad manner. Clear? That's it. All questions are there. So we have to write down some additional questions, beta. These were the long questions. Now some factual questions you should know. Write down. How did Mrs. Darling react? How did that you will answer only. How did Mrs. Darling react when daughter of Mrs. S arrives at the address? When daughter of Mrs. S arrives at the address. This is the reaction you have to tell. Yes, Gursimran, what was the reaction? Yes, she did not open the door. She opened a chink. Use textual language, preferably. Jo text mein likha hai, fine? You can use your own also. She does not want to open the door. She was hesitant of opening the door. She opened a chink only. And when she saw that she's looking and observing at my green cardigan, she became more aware and she wanted to close the door only. She did not want to interact with her. She did not recognize her straight away. Next is, who had given the narrator the address? Who had given the narrator the address, comma, when and under what circumstance? Who did give that address to Mrs. S. daughter? Who gives? Yes, Jacqueline, you tell the answer. Marconi Street address was given to narrator, daughter of Mrs. S. Whom do you think gave address to her? Yes, Mrs. S. is the correct answer. Mrs. S. once told her that about Mrs. Darling and her address, and she also asked her to remember it. She said, "Na, remember 46 Marconi Street." What does narrator remember about Mrs. Darling? What does narrator remember about Mrs. Darling as she saw her for the first time? As she saw her for the first time. Yes. Namanpreet or Ramanjeet, anyone, please answer. She remembers her as, yes, very good, Ramanjeet. A lady with a broad back, that was the first thing she remembers. And more, she wore a brown coat, that also attire you can mention. She wore a brown coat and a shapeless hat. Mrs. Darling was a woman with a broad back. She wore a brown coat and a shapeless hat. And what does she pick? Yes, Nidhi, what did she pick? कल सुनी थी क्लास में ऑनलाइन क्लास में थे आप यस दीक्षा यस हैवी सूटकेस राइट आंसर शी पिक्ड अप अ हैवी सूटकेस लाइंग अंडर द कोट रैक एंड लेफ्ट देयर हाउस दीज आर द थ्री थिंग्स शी रिमेंबर्स हाउ डिड नरेटर लास्ट क्वेश्चन How did narrator reconcile herself? Reconcile. Reconcile means adapting to that situation, accepting that situation. Raman, aapko chashma laga hua hai? Spectacles lagi hui hai? Get yourself tested. You are looking by scumming your eyes and all. Dikhne mein problem aa rahi hai na? Tell me honestly, you're having the problem by looking at the board? Then get yourself tested right now. Okay? Because we cannot, sometimes we have 0.5, minus 0.5 or minus 1 even. You should wear spectacles, fine. Aage number nahi badhta nahi to. So, how did narrator reconcile herself to the loss of her mother's precious belongings? How did narrator reconcile herself to the loss of her mother's precious belongings? Yes, tell me. Same answer. I have discussed that number of times now. Fine. Firstly, the things why she wanted to forget the address. That is the same answer to be fitted here. Fine. That how does she reconcile herself? वही answer यहाँ. Well हो चुकी है, okay? So the children who are coming to school, better kindly follow the norms discussed in the class.